Mike Fromm won here in 1971, the first road victory of his coaching career at UofL. And we're underway. And Louisville with the opening tip-off. King Legree in the backcourt will bring it over and set it up. A bad pass, but he recovered it in there to hold it.
Kansas, as expected, will play tough man-to-man defense. They'll change it up some, but they like that man-to-man D, and a little bit too tight as they get a foul right off the bat.
Right off the bat, the foul is called against Jordan. That's Adonis Jordan, one of the starting guards. As you look at Roy Williams in his fourth season here at Kansas, 87-25 record, 10 years an assistant to Dean Smith at North Carolina. High pass to Holden. The tough defense. Holden on the drive to the lane. Don't go. And Legree can't get it to fall. Legree again. It won't go. A scramble, and Kansas will come out with it on the break. And the block by Morton from behind.
Well, he made him eat it. They got back, and good defense by Morton.
Here come the Cardinals to Morton, driving, and he got it. First points of the game, Dwayne Morton on the drive and the pass from Sullivan.
A lot of intensity from Louisville offensively and on the D. Let's see how the press affects the Jayhawks, if at all.
Here it is. Driving shot, no good, and Miner will clear the board. Well, Louisville playing a very up-tempo, aggressive style of ball here early. As Sullivan drives, he's fouled. That'll go against Rex Walters, number 23. And that'll be the second foul on Kansas.
By the way, it's Larry Rose, Larry Ware, and Mike Jagg, all three officials from the Metro Conference. When they played in Louisville, they were all from the Big Eight.
Miner with the inbounds to Keith Legree. He is guarded by Adonis Jordan, number 30. In the man-to-man defense. Holding against a freshman, Ben Davis. And Legree fell down, but Miner is there to recover it. Morton will put up the shot. Good. Four quick points by Dwayne Morton, and Louisville is leading it.
He hasn't hesitated. He has the ability to score. He's shown that in the last couple of games and earlier when he had 33 against Morehead State. He needs to continue to take that shot.
Yes, the sophomore, Morton, is certainly capable of having an explosive offensive night. He just hadn't had many of them lately. None of the Cardinals have. Now Jordan with it to the top of the key. This is a pass inside for Davis. Out of bounds, Louisville.
Good pressure man-to-man defense by Louisville. And right off the bat now, Roy Williams brings Steve Woodbury off the bench, David. He likes to play seven or eight players a lot and sometimes goes to 9 and 10. And he doesn't like what he's seen so far, so he makes a change.
He's had five different starting lineups in the first 11 games.
Isn't that amazing? And he's 11-0.
Fourth ranked in the country. This is Miner. They got Legree down on the baseline. Kick it out. Miner thought about a three. And this one is up for two, and it's good by Everett Sullivan. He was on the line or inside the three-point line. And Louisville is out to a 6-0 start. 17-30. We've played a couple of minutes. Three-pointer is off the rim, and Sullivan cleans the boards. Boy, Louisville has been dominating the rebounding scene here early. Holden has it stripped away. Here comes Alonzo Jameson. And he'll hold up. Adonis Jordan driving on Legree. He backs out of there with it. There's a foul on Morton. Boy, he was putting some tight defense on Alonzo Jameson.
Yeah, he was. And Kansas has missed its first three shots in the game. Louisville, on the other hand, 3 out of 6. You see Morton right there, just a little bit of contact with his fingernails across his shirt, cost him the foul.
Substitutions in the game now for Kansas as Davis goes out. Number 51, Eric Pauley. And you see Louisville with an early rebounding edge at 5-1. And they lead the game 6-0. That'll end. That's 6-2. As Richard Scott gets the first basket of the game for the Jayhawks. So 6-2, 16-43 here in the first half. Everett Sullivan over to Legree. And he's got the shot. Gives the pass over to Morton, and he got it. And that is 6 quick points for Morton. He's got 6 of Louisville's first 8 points. 8-2, Cards with a 6-point lead. Adonis Jordan in that excellent backcourt, along with Rex Walters for Kansas. And Don mentioned maybe the best backcourt in the country, or at least one of them. This is Pauley, who came in for the freshman Davis, 51 to Jordan. This is Walter. He fires. No good. The rebound to Legree. Louisville continuing to go to those defensive boards. Sullivan, an air ball. But there was Miner to pick it up. Needs help. Didn't get it. Turns around, fires, and it's going to be a fast break. Adonis Jordan. Louisville's got it. Shots up, no good. Morton will go for the rebound. He's fouled from behind. And that's a first on Alonzo Jamison, number 24. Boy, I tell you, Don, I'm impressed with the Louisville Cardinals on the boards early. They're leading 7-3 on the rebounding.
A lot of intensity, and Roy Williams says, hey, we better be ready to play, but the Cardinals right now, the better of it.
The Cardinals have come out smoking. They lead this one 8-2.
Found the open man, Dwayne Morton, and you could see Morton thought it might come out, and he was hanging around what could have been a potential offensive rebound. Louisville's done a good job of really hustling and going to the glass at both ends.
And Kansas, with only 14% field goal shooting, and they are one of the top field goal shooting teams in America.
And they have been the last 3 years.
Shooting over 50% as a team. 54 to be exact. Now Holden, double teamed with it to Legree. Donis Jordan on him, very, very tight defense. Rex Walter comes out to pick up Sullivan. Holden. Want to go inside and do, and Cornelius with a turnaround basket, 10-2, 8-point lead.
Good patience, good shot selection. We talked about it in our Budweiser game plan.
15-04, Walter coughs it up. And turnover again as Morton, or rather Miner, threw it ahead of Sullivan and Legree. Foul going to go on Morton, I believe.
And that's two on Dwayne, David. And that was a reach-in. He can't afford to get him in some foul trouble this early.
That's two on him. You're exactly right. And we have just played a few seconds over 5 minutes in this game. And you can see the shooting and the way it has disintegrated for Louisville in the last few games. First six games, shooting over 51% from the field, 41% from three-point range. Three-point shooting now down to 19.3% over the last four games. Overall at 42. Morton is out, and Derwin Webb is in for UofL. An 8-point early lead over Kansas, undefeated, and playing on their home court. This is Walter.
See the patience of Kansas here, David. They'll look for the good shot and get it inside.
And they do go inside, and the basket is good by Jamison. And now a 6-point lead as Louisville comes back to try to get it back up to 8. Sullivan, nice pass to Derwin Webb, and he is fouled as he drives into the lane.
You know, things are happening for Louisville, David, because the Cardinals are taking the ball to the basket. You see the penetration by Sullivan, finds the open Derwin Webb, and I mean, he is really hammered on the noggin. Different angle, but the penetration made it happen. And Webb, strong to the basket.
And Derwin Webb now will stand up to the free throw line. He's been hitting 70% in limited play. One of the few Cardinals that's been hitting well from the free throw line as a team. UofL hitting 63%. Oh, he missed the first one. And free throw shooting has been costly for the Cardinals, particularly in that Tulane game, which they lost after missing 13.
Last two games, 29 of 51 free throw shooting.
Nailed that one, 11-4, 7-point lead. 8 has been Louisville's biggest lead early. And that was at 10-2. Woodbury, number 20 with it, guarded by Holden, intercepted, picked off there by Miner. Alert defense by the Cardinals. Miner will take the three. Bottoms up.
Oh, they said he was on the line. Denny Crum wanted a three, but they said his foot was on the paint.
So they give him a two-pointer. And it's 13-4. Foul on Holden. That'll be his first, team third.
Well, the other thing we talked about in the Budweiser game plan, the final thing that has been played down here in Lawrence was the focus of Kansas. The other thing we did mention is Roy Williams was very frank with us today, David. He said, hey, we haven't played the toughest schedule in the world yet, and Denny Crum's club will come in here ready to play. We better be ready, and they haven't been at this point.
Louisville maintaining a 9-point lead, the biggest lead they've had so far at 13-4. 13:35 to go. We're in the opening half of play. Richie is in the game, number 12. Jordan, he'll fire it up for three, no good, and Derwin Webb clears the rebound.
One shot for Kansas. They're a good rebounding team, but Louisville doing a good job blocking out on the boards.
Now Kansas applies the defense. Miner flips it over to Legree to let him set it up as the clock works down to 13 minutes here in the first half at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. We got a foul on Troy Smith away from the ball, and that'll turn it over to Kansas.
And Troy's had that problem the last couple of games. Denny Crum, I don't think, is in agreement with that. He's talking to Larry Ware about it right now. But Troy's picked up a couple of offensive fouls in the last two games, and he's pointing something out over against Richie now, who checked into the lineup for the Jayhawks.
And Ostertag, number 00, is in, a 7'2" center freshman. Ostertag with Troy Smith trying to front him out at the top of the key. Well, Kansas trying to get their offense into gear.
But you see their patience. They're looking for the good shot. They have the big, big lineup inside.
Louisville just hadn't been able, hasn't given them anything. Shot clock winding down to 5 seconds. Here's the shot clock winding down. Richie hits it from the corner. Three-pointer. Patrick Richie, and it's a 13-7, 6-point UofL lead. Miner in the lane is stopped by Oster. And at 7'2", Ostertag, one of the tallest men in college basketball. And he stuffed Miner.
This is what Kansas can do. Success out of the half-court game. They ran down the shot clock, and they've got a big three. Richie's a good outside shooter.
Richie with a height advantage on Legree. Over to Woodbury. Driving by to Richie, and he balked it. But Ostertag puts it in. And the basket will count, and the foul is on Miner.
Well, Roy Williams club not getting it from the starters, so he goes to the bench. First of all, Richie hits the three. Now watch Ostertag block, first of all, inside. Ostertag with the offensive follow-up, and he draws the foul for Miner. That's why Roy Williams likes his club. He has some depth. David, he lost three starters plus his sixth man off that team that went to the Final Four last year, and he's off to an 11-0 start and fourth ranking. He likes his talent.
Greg Ostertag, Duncanville, Texas, a freshman, as we mentioned, and they claim he still may be growing. He's put on 2 inches and 75 pounds in the last couple of years. And Kansas has very quickly trimmed Louisville's lead to three. It's 13-10.
But Dave, the freshman, Ostertag, has made a difference on offense, but watch him on defense. Good block against Miner. He's 7'2". He didn't need to jump. He didn't need to lean in. He just put that big, long Texas arm straight up. And as you can see, that's one of the two blocks that Kansas had on the game. Louisville, on the other hand, has rejected three shots as well. But the Jayhawks now getting some confidence, and it's coming from the bench. The bench has been focused.
And the Jayhawks have youth in the middle with Ben Davis, who started in the pivot as a freshman. And then you have Ostertag coming off the bench, also a freshman.
And Kansas on a 6-0 run right now.
And it's 13-10 as we go back to play. Louisville had a 9-point lead at 13-4. And it has been whittled away.
A little trapping defense this time.
Sullivan is cold. He can't hit it, and it bounced away. And the rebound comes off to Richard Scott. Ben Davis drives, and Troy Smith was there to block it, and he fouled it. That's two on Troy Smith, who came in off the bench. And Louisville continues to pile up the fouls. It'll be 16 fouls.
Well, you see the penetration. That's what Kansas is doing now. And Scott actually gets Troy Smith to commit the foul with that penetration. You see Holden back in for Louisville as Smith will go out. But Kansas now, if they don't get the outside shot, looking to push it inside to the big guys, creating some fouls and going to the line.
Scott missed. And he's a pretty good free throw shooter, 38%.
Not very good.
He struggled at the line.
It's an adventure when he walks up there.
And he's 0 for 2. And the rebound off of there, whether it'll throw it out at 11 minutes to go. Louisville up by 3. They got off to a 6-0 lead on Kansas. Double team foul is going to go on Woodbury, the sophomore out of Wichita, Kansas.
Now, David, you see the double team changing the defense. How will the Cardinals adjust to this in this game situation? Well, that time they had the benefit of the foul and get the ball back. But Kansas likes to change defense or steal.
Well, they just picked up one, and now a whistle out at midcourt. Over and back is called. As Kip Stone had thrown the ball away. And have a lot of boos here in Allen Fieldhouse for the call of over and back.
Let's see. Hard to tell. You got to have the ball and both feet in the front court before you can make a backcourt violation.
Well, it's over to Louisville now. Still by 3. They go to Holden. The Cardinals still going to the inside. Still trying to work it into the paint. And Oster tag is out of there right now, the 7-2. Holden with a jumper off the front of the rim. And now Kansas trailing by 3. Throw it away. Well, the Jayhawks with a turnover.
Yeah, and again, though, they were trying to get it inside. I think Roy Williams decided, hey, maybe we can get Louisville in some foul trouble. They already got Morton over on the bench. And you notice how the offense has dropped off since Morton went to the bench? 10 turnovers in the game so far, too.
Derwin Webb banked it in. Nice play by Derwin Webb, his first field goal. Back to a 5-point lead at 15-10. And Kansas throws it away, and Louisville will get it back.
Trying to get the easy basket. Roy Williams, what a great job he has done.
And fabulous job, and a very personable and very candid coach when you sit down and talk to him.
Yeah, he is. Last year he was the National and Big 8 Coach of the Year.
Louisville with a 5-point lead as the clock is now inside 10 minutes in the first half. Everett Sullivan to Holden. And now Miner, no good, but Holden with a rebound. Cardinals doing a good job on the boards, but Holden cannot get the ball to fall. Walters. Loose ball on the floor. Who's going to get it? Scramble down in the lane. Almost 7 of the 10 players on the court are involved in that play. Well, only 3 players left standing.
You know what? When Dr. James Naismith invented this game and was the first basketball coach here at the University of Kansas, as we celebrate our 100th year, this is the way he meant for the game to be played. Loose ball on the floor. One guy's got it. No, I don't have it. There's another guy. Nope, you got it. We're going to all get down on the floor and go after that leather. Both teams really going after it there. That's the way you play the game.
Kansas with it back at 9:28. And the foul is on Kansas inside. And that turns it over.
I think Scott was pushing off 34 in the white. That's who they got.
And that'll be 16 fouls now on Kansas. We're live with you here from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Louisville with a 7-3 record, trying to break out of a shooting slump, losing 3 of their last 4 against unbeaten and fourth-ranked Kansas. Foul's going to go on Jamison from behind on Holden. Alonzo Jamison, considered by the Kansas people and by many people around America to be one of the best defensive players in the college game.
No question about it. Matter of fact, he's one of the players that they feel is not only one of the best players in the Big 8 defensively in the country, as you mentioned, he feels that he might even go on to the next level because his defense has been so good. He was the most consistent player overall last year for the Jayhawks, and you see Roy Williams going to his bench again as he brings in Nash.
Malcolm Nash, a senior out of St. Louis, as Holden hits the foul shot. The Cards are one out of three from the line early here tonight. And that makes it 16-10.
Denny Crum got his first road win ever as a collegiate basketball coach at UofL right in this building.
17-10. Cards open up the lead over the Jayhawks at 9:14. Whistle and the foul, I believe, is on.
I think they got Webb, I believe.
Derwin Webb, 13. That'll be his first.
Derwin,
and that's the 17 foul.
He didn't like it either, David. He said, you got to be kidding me.
You know any player that likes to get a foul call,
no,
though?
No, but Derwin's one of those guys, too, that just has such intensity. That's why Denny Crum likes to have him on the floor, because he's one of those guys that says, hey, we can turn it around. And Derwin Webb's a guy that plays hard every time he puts on those sneakers.
Adonis Jordan at 5'11", smallest man on the court here tonight. Deadly from the free throw line. He hits 77% this season there. You know, Adonis Jordan's three-point shooting percentage at 56%.
He leads him in scoring, tops and assists. Actually, second in scoring, just a little bit behind his buddy and roommate Rex Walters, to transfer from Northwestern.
It's 2-for-2 to make it 17-12. Clips Louisville's lead down to 5. Guard's biggest lead has been 9 at 13-4.
Here's a trap again.
Here's Webb open along the baseline with a move, and he couldn't get the shot to fall, but he did draw the foul from Kansas down inside.
Game adjustments, the half-court trap, changing of the defense by Kansas. But the recognition that time by Legree, and Webb may have the quickest first step of any player I've ever seen. And that's why he gets to that baseline so quickly and has an opportunity to go to the line a lot.
He's been to the line twice tonight. He's hit one. Make it 2 now for 3. 2 out of 3. 18-12 as that boost the Louisville lead back to 6. The Cardinals have never trailed in this first half. And Webb, 2-for-2, 3 out of 4 for the night, 19-12. Back to a 7-point advantage for the Cardinals.
This is the denial press here.
Clock has just gone inside 9 minutes first half. A couple of players come up off the Kansas bench. Roy Williams make more changes. He's really working them in and out. Here's Kip Stone with a steal. Oh, he lost the handle on it. Had the break going, and now he throws it away. Adonis Jordan will lead the Jayhawks. Pass to Richard, and it's good. And he's fouled. Rex Walters, first field goal of the game. He's their leading scorer.
Well, Kip Stone had the steal and lost it. Could have caught the ball. Instead, turns it back over. And you see Walters. He's a southpaw, so that was the natural shot for him to put it in. Different angle, same result. Roommates. And they team up on a nice play here, and Walters could cap off a three-point opportunity at the line.
Rex Walters, a junior. He's out of San Jose, California. I think it's interesting, out of the starting lineup for Kansas, not a single player from the state of Kansas.
Yeah, that really surprised me, not the world's largest populated state.
Shot by Walter. He got it, and he is an 81% shooter from the line, so you can pretty well bet he's going to connect.
Now the full court pressure by Kansas. See how Louisville handles it.
Rex Walters' three-point play has put the lead down to 4 at 19-15. And Tremaine Wingfield scores, who just came in off the bench, to make it 21-15.
And David, once again, Legree saw the opening after he broke the press, pushed it to the floor toward the basket. That's why Wingfield was open.
Louisville's had a lead of 9. They've had 7-point leads and 8-point leads. Oster with a follow. He scored 5 points, the big 7-2 freshman.
Say, that guy can really move around, too. He's not gawky at all for 7-2.
Very well coordinated, and Kip Stone surprised him and just drove by the 7-foot-2 and loaded it in there. 23-17, Cards by 6. 7:41 to go in the half. Well, Oosterhouse missed it for Sullivan. Oostertag has been a scoring machine here tonight. 7 points.
But did you notice his good hands? He missed it, got his own rebound, and he's got these Jayhawk students who never sit down, really up in arms.
Louisville's lead at 4, 23-19. Holden on Ostertag. Here's a three-pointer by Stone, and he hit it. Tip Stone, that's the first three-point shot tonight for the Cards.
And it's only the second in the last three games.
Seven-point lead, though, 26-19. Every time you think Kansas is going to close the gap, Louisville responds. And Tip Stone comes up with it in the corner.
Wingfield, good help defense to slap it away.
So far, Louisville has played put on a very good effort in the first half. Irwin Webb has it knocked out of bounds. Louisville's ball. Off the bench, back into the game. Everick Sullivan, Kip Stone, he did a good job and leaves. We got a timeout on the court here at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, where Louisville leads by seven. Throughout the first half, Louisville is leading it by seven.
There's the penetration you saw by Legree, and as a result, the easy basket by Tremaine Wingfield.
You see the score, 26-19. Louisville got off to a roaring start, 6-0, before Kansas scored. A 9-point lead at 13-4 was Louisville's biggest of the game so far. They've had a 7-point lead, 8-point lead. Right now it stands at 7. And Louisville with the ball inbounds to Legree. Cardinals coming off a very disappointing game at Virginia Commonwealth where they scored under 60 points. Here is Hopgood driving and gets the basket to go, but he charged. Will the basket count?
I don't think so. Nope, they waved it off.
So Brian Hopgood gets the foul.
There you see it. Got to go straight up. That's what Denny Crum was doing. You got to go straight up. Don't lean in. That would be a turnover. That's only the sixth of Louisville in the game. Kansas has 10.
Kansas with the ball, and they're trying to clip into that 7-point Louisville lead as we go to 6 minutes in the first half. Shot from the side is good. Three-pointer by Pat Ritchie.
You got to get out on these guys. Doesn't matter who it is. Maybe except for Ostertag. Everybody else will launch that three.
And that's two of them by Ritchie in this game. Everick Sullivan throws a ill-advised shot up. No good.
Not a good shot.
Forced that one up.
Poor selection.
Wide open, Ben Davis. First basket for Davis. It's a two-point game, 26-24 Louisville. The crowd now really getting loud, getting behind the Jayhawks. Tremaine Wingfield, he's at home along that baseline.
Yeah, he is. And, you know, I'm surprised Tremaine probably will start getting more playing time. Every time he has played this year, he's played very well.
Here's a shot by Jordan. Hit the bottom. Another by Woodbury. His first basket, 28-26. .450 to go in the first half. Ritchie has sparked the Jayhawks with his three-point shooting. Legree, under fire, hits it. That's his first basket.
Banked it in, and Keith's really been struggling with his shooting. Maybe that'll give him some confidence out there.
30-26, 4:25 to go in the half. Kansas, they go inside, and they've got Pauley. They're going to wave it off and hit the foul on Hopgood.
You know, David, Kansas likes to run this motion offense in Louisville with the switching defense. Somebody gets lost. There you see Hopgood in the position. Little bump, not much contact, but they got him on the foul.
Well, Hopgood will go over to the bench, and Cornelius Holden returns to the game. Miner is in along with Sullivan and Legree and Tremaine Wingfield, who scored two baskets here, both of them along the baseline. And so we go to the foul line. Eric Pauley. And a Buena Park, California, a 6'10 junior, a 71% free throw shooter. And Kansas, now you can't let that happen, controls it off the missed free throw.
Everybody's got a block out.
Walters lost the handle, Woodbury did, and turns it over to Louisville. 30-27. The Cardinals by three at Allen Fieldhouse in Kansas. They got 4:08 to go.
Here's the double team, needs help.
Miner's in trouble, gets it over to Holden. Now Holden will go to the baseline and he's fouled. And that will go on Nash.
Here you see Holden. And they got, I believe, Scott. Looked like
yeah, that's
contact.
Scott. Number 34, Scott. Holden has hit one out of one tonight. He's got 3 points.
You talk about distractions for free throw shooters. Danny Crum's team is looking into the student section that does something a little bit different each time. Very, very distracting. So you really need the concentration. About it doing it again, a violation.
Yeah, violation. Level Holden will get to go back to the line and try that one again.
Is it hot in this building or what?
It's getting hotter.
15-8, and I mean they're packed in here.
And there's timeout on the court as Holden hits the free throw. Louisville is back up on top of this game by five with 3:53 to go in the half. Arizona, 89-87. And the big upset of the day saw Notre Dame knock off North Carolina at Madison Square Garden by 12. And Minnesota, a winner over Michigan in an upset of the Big Ten, 73-64. After losing by more than 40 to Indiana, Minnesota sure bounced back today. And that's the AmeriCall long-distance scoreboard. Kansas, as Woodbury puts it up, it's in and out. And shot won't fall. Didn't save it in time. The official says he was out of bounds. As Nash was down on the floor.
David, these last 3.5 minutes, very important. As we watch it again, comes off there. Wingfield actually got pushed, but you could obviously see that it out of bounds. Nash was there trying to get it.
We're inside 3.5 minutes of the first half as Legree works on Woodbury. And Miners. The clock moves down to 3 minutes. Eric Sullivan passed up a shootout opportunity there. He hasn't really had the hot hand going in the first half.
And you know, Louisville put Morton on the bench with those two quick fouls, and he hasn't been back since.
Good point. Holden has it knocked away, but recovered it. Now Wingfield, he doesn't want to shoot from that spot. They'll send him back inside. Holden, it could have been a foul call there, but there wasn't. Shot will not go, and Wingfield tried but failed to get the rebound. Kansas now trying to cut into the lead as Holden has picked up another foul. That'll be two on Cornelius Holden. Two on Morton, two on Holden, two on Hopgood, and two on Troy Smith. It's 32-27 with 2:42 in the half.
Kansas has really picked up on the shooting, David. They've had 10 out of 21. Louisville 12 of 25. That was after a very, very slow shooting start by the Jayhawks.
Interesting note on Malcolm Nash. He's a triplet. Native of St. Louis. Nash is a reserve. He's averaging under 4 points a game. A senior.
You know, you can imagine maybe Louisville would have been in even better shape had Morton not gotten that early foul trouble. We haven't seen him since then.
Well, Sullivan comes off with it. Walters was on the back of somebody there and could have been tagged with a foul, but was not called. There he comes up with a steal, and he gets the foul this time. And if he complains, he got away with one under the basket on the inbound. Yep. They get him outside. Second foul on Rex Walters.
Yeah, Roy Williams is upset about it, but watch it. On the replay, a little bumping already. He shoved Sullivan out of the way. That's why they called the foul, not because he made contact on the steal. That came at the head of that play where he actually took his right hand and pushed Sullivan back. That's why he got what appeared to be a clean steal.
That's two on Rex Walters and Sullivan at the line. 3 points for Everett Sullivan, who's averaging just under 15 points a game.
Roy Williams is still complaining about it.
It was a good call. Two for two. 34-28. Louisville by six. 2:28 to go. Walters inside. The shot is up and good by Richard Scott. Holden at the other end, and he's fouled as he was going up for the shot by Nash.
Good awareness by Louisville that Kansas did not get back on defense and almost got the gimme. You see it on one end. There is the shot down low. Nice reverse shot by Scott. Now, when it goes out of bounds, and Miner, who's great with the baseball pass, well, we didn't see the end of it. We saw the basket by Scott, but Miner made a terrific pass, recognizing the fact that Holden was open.
Holden has had a perfect night at the line. Now, he missed one, but he got it over again because of a violation. Benny Crum coaching on the bench with Brian Hopgood, who's been in a couple of minutes and had some trouble defensively and went back to the bench. Well, Holden is red hot from the free throw line. 36-30, Louisville by six. And on the press, a whistle, and that'll turn it over. They did not get the ball in within 5 seconds.
Louisville's done a good job defensively, changing it up that time with the denial press. Roy Williams now going to get Nash out of there as he brings Davis back in. But Louisville's had a couple of different variations out of the press and has confused Kansas at times.
So the clock works its way down to the two-minute mark, and Louisville with a six-point lead in the ball. Holden has got the move inside, and he mistimed his jump. I think he thought there were people closer to him underneath than actually were.
Yeah, but he's got to jam that home. He's in that position. He can jump. Should have had it.
Rex Walter misfires on a three. Holden's got this rebound. Now, this has been a surprise in the first half to see Louisville at 7-3 lead Kansas throughout. Perfect pass to Miner, who's fouled.
Great back door that
time.
The
shot did not go, but what a pass.
Yeah, it was. Great back door, Miner and Legree. Communication. Look at that. Recognition first, the back break. The shot almost goes down. Miner was really upset. He wanted a chance at a three-point play.
And that's the third foul on Richard Scott, who goes over to the Kansas bench. The Cardinals have been spending a lot of time at the free throw line here tonight. This is the first time we've seen Miner. The sophomore out of Sandersville, Georgia, has 1 or 2 points so far. Miner's been hitting 74% from the line, and although he didn't hit that one.
That's what he's looking at, David. They're doing it different this time. They'll change it up next time they shoot.
Well, if that was the problem or not, he went 0 for 2. Minute 30, and the clock runs. Louisville by 6. Kansas with the ball, but Pauley had to retrieve that one. He almost lost it. Adonis Jordan will take it outside. Shot clock's at 26. Game clock at a minute and 12.
Good movement by Kansas.
They get it inside to Pauley, and the shot is blocked. Now here's the long pass to Everick Sullivan. And that'll turn it right back over to Kansas with a minute and 1 second to go.
You got to catch the ball and not think about shooting before that. Everick was thinking about what he was going to do. Great block here by Holden. He slaps it away. They push it down the floor. Again, Miner was the guy that was going to throw it away.
That'll be the 14th block of the year for Holden. See the turnover margin. Little has played a very clean first half. Woodbury wide open. Hit it. 4 points for Woodbury. 4-point lead for Louisville. 36, you see the clock in the bottom of your screen.
Need the last shot here, David. Need to take the final shot of the half.
36-32, Louisville by four. Now as it moves inside, 20 seconds to the inside, 15 seconds. Here goes Legree. Now at the 10-second mark. They get it to Holden, flips it over, and they're going to call a charge on Holden.
Well, you know, prior to that, somebody had Holden by the back of the jersey. That was very obvious. Somebody, it might have been a Cardinal, I don't know.
Well,
but watch right here. Look at here. He grabbed his jersey, and then they get an offensive foul on Holden. That's pretty weak.
That is pretty weak. That's three fouls now on Cornelius Holden, too. As he goes out. It's a four-point Louisville lead. Seconds ticking away. Shots up. No good. And Louisville will go to the locker room with a four-point lead. They led by up to nine. Any way you slice it, it's been a good first half of basketball for the Cardinals. And we'll be back with halftime activities right after we take this.
Dallas, and happy 40th birthday to a big UofL fan, Karen Brown.
All right, back to action. Four-point Louisville lead. Kansas has not had the lead in this game. Ranked fourth in the country. The Jayhawks at home, where they almost never lose. Inside 20 minutes left to play in this one. It is the same lineup with one exception. Troy Smith has opened up in place of Holden with three fouls, who is on the bench. And Troy Smith just gets another foul, and that'll be three on him.
And I don't know what it is, but it has happened to Troy Smith in the last three ball games. All of his fouls have been on the offensive end. He's not going to stay in very long. Brian Hopgood is going to replace Smith. Denny Crum's going to walk him to the bench and talk to him. And I don't know why Holden didn't start to begin the second half.
Except with the three personal fouls, for some reason, he opened it up on the bench. And Hopgood could be a defensive liability against this quick Kansas team. Inside, it's bouncing around, and Louisville's got it. Well, the Cardinals a four-point lead and throw it right into the teeth of the Kansas defense.
Yeah, a sloppy pass by Keith Legree. Louisville's taking good care of the ball, but that was not a good start offensively.
The opening stages of the second half could be very critical in this game. Walters tried the three, did not get it. Hopgood misses on the rebound. And there is the foul as Hopgood and Morton were up fighting for it. And Morton will get the foul.
That's tough on Dwayne Morton. It looked like that was a great play. Here's where Hopgood's a liability. He's not a great jumper. So you see the rebound. Oh, man. There might have been a little contact on the arm after the shot. But that's tough. He's going to...
Ben Davis, 2 points in the first half. A freshman that opens up in the starting lineup for the Jayhawks. Well, that's three fouls committed by Morton. So he and Holden... each with three, and Troy Smith. Just out of the reach, and Walter hits the three.
Now they gave him two. Said he was on
gave
the
him
line.
A two-pointer. Rex Walters cuts it to a one-point game, 36-35.
Louisville needs a basket in its worst way. Need to be patient, get a good shot here.
Hopgood with a dangerous pass over into the corner. Morton misses. And Rex Walter comes out of there with a rebound. And he throws it away, but it's out of bounds. Kansas will keep it.
Tremendous job by Morton to bust his tail to get back on defense and deflect that away and stop the Kansas fast break.
Well, we have played a minute and a half here in the second half, and Kansas with a three leads or trails it by one at 36-35 and can take the lead here for the first time in the game. Jameson gives them the lead at 37-36 at 18-14.
Now let's see how the Cardinals handle the adversity. They're on their feet and screaming in the Allen Fieldhouse.
Legree turns it over. Jordan, he's fouled from behind by Legree. And that's the first foul for Legree. And a Jordan will go up to the line.
Well, the defense, lazy pass by Legree. Now watch these college roommates and teammates. Good combination. Legree thought he had all ball, but they got him on a foul. And it's going to be a timeout, Louisville.
And Don Russell back here at Allen Fieldhouse. The first lead of the game by the Jayhawks at 37-36. At the line for foul shooting is Adonis Jordan. Jordan, who is averaging 14.5 a game, has scored two tonight.
Yeah, Louisville's done a good job on him, but he's the one that really makes it go with assist and scoring.
That's a two-point lead for Kansas at 38-36.
You know, the last three games, this guy shot 70% from the floor, David. That's not too shabby.
And Kansas by three has outscored Louisville 7-0 to start the second half. They lead the game by three and put the pressure on the Cardinals, who inbounds it. Here's Morton. Shot won't go. Rebound Louisville, up and in. The other end, in and out, and Hopgood has the rebound. And it's over to Miner. He threw it away. Rex Walters on the drive, and he got it. 41-38.
You know, Walters is the guy that wanted to come to Kansas when he was in high school. Roy Williams wasn't coaching him. He wasn't recruited, transferred from Northwestern.
Well, there's a turnover for Louisville. Back to Kansas. So the Jayhawks, leading by three, have the ball back. And Hopgood, who let that one get through his hands and go out of bounds, leaves. And with three fouls, Cornelius Holden comes back. Denny Crum's got to find a lineup that can stop the bleeding. They're down by three. Louisville's only scored 2 points in the second half. On the follow, it's Jameson.
Didn't block out. Got to get those rebounds. The second shot can kill you every time.
5-point lead, 43-38 for Kansas. 16-42, and Louisville turns it over, but walking against Kansas.
You know, David, I think what happened is Kansas has come out to begin the second half with the same intensity that Louisville came out with to begin the ball game, and that's one of the reasons we've had this turnaround.
It will be very tough for the Cardinals to recapture that kind of momentum in a hostile environment like we have here at Allen Fieldhouse. Not to say they can't do it, but it will be tougher. Sullivan in the lane, forced it up and got it. Everick Sullivan now with six. Only a second field goal. 43-40, Kansas with a three-point lead. Woodbury, who's come into the game, goes in, and it's a turnover, and Louisville has it as Legree to Holden, and rolls off, and no foul on the inside. Jordan on the break, Jameson. Jameson with 6 points in the second half.
It's a costly turn of events. Morton created the steal. Holden had an easy shot, didn't get it. And then the score by Kansas.
45-40 as Everick Sullivan can't get it to go. Holden tries to get one up. Morton tapped up and in by Greg Miner. 4 points for Greg Miner. 45-42, Kansas. They put that one on Miner, and that would be the second on Greg Miner.
You know, Kansas is having pretty good success of getting the ball inside uncontested. See, they're behind Ritchie here, and Miner wanted to pick up a charge, but Ritchie went the other way. He didn't go to the basket, so Miner gets the block for Denny Crum's team.
Richard Scott is out of the lineup for Kansas. Ben Davis with it. As Paulie is into the game, 51. He's wide open, screaming for the ball, and a mismatch with Legree down in the paint.
Yeah,
Jordan will get it to him. No way Legree can defense somebody 6'10". Legree is 6'1", and Eric Paulie gets the basket.
Yeah, that's the downside of the switching man-to-man. You get mismatches like that, and nobody was able to get back and switch in time, and Legree was helpless.
Martin. Shot dropped, and the foul is called.
Adonis Jordan wanted a push off on Morton. He ain't going to get that. That was a terrific play by Dwayne Morton.
It was indeed, and the foul is called on Kansas. It goes against Patrick Ritchie.
Watch the penetration. Up, the shot, got the bounce, and draws the foul. Different angle, Well, this is at the other end. This is where Richie had it, and he banked it in.
Now we got Morton at the foul line for the first time in the game. No good. Miner is beaten to the ball there by Walters. So Kansas leading by three. Inside Davis. He missed. It was wide open inside, and Louisville will come out of the game with it, or come out of there with it. Over to Holden inside. He's fouled and hammered. Ostertag. That's his first. 47-44. Kansas.
Now you see the push up the floor. Holden takes it to the basket strong. Here's the reach and the slap across the wrist. 4-1 and the ball to go down with an opportunity to three-point play, but instead it goes just to the line.
Holden has hit six times on the foul line as you look at Kansas bench. Roy Williams.
Quite a collection of ties among those three assistants there.
You can't miss them.
They were trying to make a fashion statement here in lovely Lawrence, Kansas.
Holden now 7-for-7. This is for the first time, but Everett Sullivan fights for the rebound. Oster tag blocked it, but the foul is called on Kansas, and the Cardinals will go right back to the line. As this time, the foul goes against Ben Davis. That's his third.
You see the great hustle by Sullivan. Tries to reverse it back up, draws the foul. I tell you what, I may be way off base, but Ostertag's a true freshman. I remember Felton Spencer when he was a freshman. He didn't have near this coordination or balance with his body around the basket. I think you're going to hear big news from this 7-foot freshman. Boy, he's finished as a collegiate player.
Foul shots are awfully important at this stage of this close game. Sullivan one out of two, 47-46. Jayhawks by one over the Cards. And there's a turnover. Well, Louisville comes up with another break. A chance to take the lead back. Sullivan, this is a three-pointer. He just can't get one to fall. Go to Ostertag. They had the mismatch again. They had poor old Keith Legree trapped inside on Ostertag, and that is about a foot height advantage for Ostertag.
Well, you see the recognition. Matter of fact, Miner tried to come over and help that time. This guy doesn't need to jump. He's a monster. It's the monster match right there.
9 points for Ostertag. Kansas making more substitutions as Ostertag will be at the line. He's 1-for-1 in the first half.
Got a great touch, doesn't he?
Very soft touch, and it's a tie or a 2-for-2 at the line and a 50-46 lead for Kansas. A lot of time to go, 14-10 in this game. Double team on Morton, and they call a foul on Kansas. And that'll go on Patrick Ritchie, number 12, his second. And that is now 14 fouls on the Jayhawks. Cardinals with five.
Need a good percentage shot here.
Morton goes in, and the basket is good, and he's fouled. Big play by Dwayne Morton.
David, I tell you what, I see more and more each game this talented sophomore beginning to pick up the slack on offense. That's why we highlighted him in the pregame. He's got a great job, great touch. Unfortunately, he got an early foul trouble, but he hasn't let it affect him now that he has three fouls. Great balance. I mean, he does so many things with his body that allows him to get that bank shot down, and then he draws the foul.
And he makes a three-point play. 10 points, 11 points in the game now for Morton. 50-49, Louisville trails by one. Ritchie hits it. Or Walters, rather. That's 6 points in the second half for Rex Walters. Walters, who set out last season after transferring from Northwestern, has been a main cog in Kansas's offense this year.
You know, going back to his finishing days at Northwestern, and here he's 34 straight games in double figures.
Morton again. Dwayne Morton, 7 points in the second half, 13 in the game, keeping Louisville close. Down by one. Jamison in the lane. He walked with it. He was trying to get a foul on Cornelius Holden. They're going to work it inside to Ostertag, and the other big fellas to try to get more the fourth foul on either Holden or Morton.
No question about it. That's the strategy, and no question they do that. You can see Louisville, five less turnovers than the Jayhawks in the game.
Official called time here momentarily to clean the basketball with a towel as Derwin Webb comes off the Louisville bench, and they'll let him come into the game.
I think Morton needs a blow here.
Morton has been playing with a lot of intensity.
You know, Dwayne Morton, Denny Crum made a very interesting point. He plays with so much emotion, David. No question how hard he plays, but he said, I need to learn to teach Dwayne to bottle that outward emotion because he said it takes some of his physical ability out on the floor away from him. Too much emotion can get on a negative side for you as well.
Louisville will have a chance here to get the lead back. They never trailed in the first half, but Kansas came out, reeled off seven straight points to open the second half and lead by one. This is a three, and it's good by Everett Sullivan.
Well, he needed that.
He keeps pumping away from out there and finally got one to go, and Louisville has the lead, 54-52. Walters to Ostertag. Just launched that very high, and you can't overthrow Ostertag.
No, but did you notice his hands, how he caught the ball? Most big guys, 7-2, that would have been right off their noggin.
23 seconds on the shot clock. Jordan, they left him open. And I have told you that Jordan is deadly from three-point range. They're going to call the jump ball as Holden and Ostertag were fighting for it.
Denny Crum thought he, the big 7-2 freshman, went over the back that time to tie up Holden. That's what he was complaining about.
Well, Louisville has got the lead in this game for the first time since losing it after Kansas made that 7-0 run. The over possession arrow to Louisville, or rather to Kansas. That's a couple of times that the Jayhawks have had trouble with the inbounds play.
Yeah, they
had a 5-second call in the first half, and this time Rex Walters just bounced it off the leg.
Yeah, and Roy Williams gets the big 7-2 Ostertag out of there as he brings Davis back in.
Whistle and a foul. Derwin Webb.
Boy, Larry Rose came from all the way the other side of the court. Mike Jagg and Larry Ware were standing right where the action was. He detected something.
Two on Webb, and Louisville comes up with a ball. A Cardinals up by two, 12-17 to go. Allen Fieldhouse, Lawrence, Kansas. Cardinals have led this game by nine, just threw it away.
Lack of communication right there. Too close together. Need to spread it out. Denny Crum shouting out the encouragement, though. Team played well.
We got Walters open for three. Does not go, but we got a foul on Kansas inside fighting for position. And that'll be
Scott,
the sixth team foul on the Jayhawks. And that's the fourth foul on Scott. Oh, the Cardinals with another chance to build on a four-point lead. Inside 12 minutes left to play. And again, they turn it over, but this time they recover. Sullivan with a jump shot. It won't go, and Kansas with a rebound. And now the Jayhawks down by two. They're still working it inside. Shot doesn't go, trying to get that fourth foul on Holden.
Louisville's done a tremendous job on the boards in this game. Rebounding, very, very solid.
Miner with it. He's only got 4 points, the sophomore. He's got trouble. And there's a foul. This is on Davis. He was all over Cornelius Holden. That Kansas is coming right after Holden, both ends of the court.
Yep.
So Davis now has four fouls.
Miner gets in some trouble out here, but he finds Holden, or tries to, and Korn was trying to get after the ball, but Ben Davis was holding him, and now you're going to see Davis go out.
And Ostertag will come back in. But Davis and Scott now with four fouls, three each on Morton and Holden and Troy Smith for UofL. And Holden, 6-for-6 in the first half, hit his first seven before missing. 9 points tonight for Cornelius Holden, the senior.
You know, Dave, going into this game, some of the Cardinal fans that are here are mentioned back all the way from Jacksonville, Florida. Well, there's, as I mentioned, there's about 150 to 200 of them here, and they all came down and talked to us before the game, and they're excited about being here.
Cornelius Holden connects with two out of two, 11-12 to go. The Cards are back up by four over the Jayhawks here to want to stay in that elite company of the undefeated teams. Now, if you're from the Kansas point of view, they have got a fight on their hands with the Cardinals here tonight.
No question about it. And Roy Williams, as we mentioned, was very candid with us. He said, Louisville is the best team we've played this year. It's going to be tough.
Here's the home run ball, and it's going to go back over to Louisville.
You know, that graphic backs up what we hit on the top of the telecast, David. 24 straight here, 30 non-conference consecutive wins in this building. Louisville will get the ball back, but, of course, since it wasn't touched in bounds, they'll get it right beneath their own basket.
That's a break for the Cards. Here's Legree. Holden being pushed backwards. Derwin Webb launches it back here to Legree, and Adonis Jordan has him covered, so he'll set up the offense. Clock's inside 11 minutes. Legree in trouble. Morton, who is back in the game, along with Kip Stone, as Denny Crum made some changes at that timeout. There's Walters taking it away, and Morton commits a silly foul.
And
he grabbed him by the jersey.
Yeah. I don't think he really grabbed him. I don't think he meant it to be an intentional foul in the sense that, we'll watch it. He was frustrated. We'll watch it go here. He grabbed him, but see, there's no way he was going to stop him from going anywhere with that grab, but that's what they interpret as an intentional foul. So it's not only his fourth, it's even more costly because Walters will get two free throws, and Kansas will get possession of the ball as Louisville commits its 15th turnover.
And Walters is an 81% foul shooter.
See, that's where I disagree with the intentional foul. Had he really grabbed his jersey and said, hey, there's no way you're going to get away, but there's no way that play would have kept him from scoring.
A 10th point for Walters. Trims Louisville's lead to three.
Coach Crum has spent a lot of time with this young team talking to him over on the sideline in situations like this. That's big play there, Dave.
Indeed. 2-point lead now as Martin is over on the bench now with four fouls. That's a very costly play. It lets Kansas creep a little bit closer and keep possession of the basketball now with a chance to tie or take the lead back. Driving for the basket. That's 8 points this half for Alonzo Jamison. And 10 points in the game. He's a defensive specialist who averages 9 points a game, but this half, he's been an offensive explosion. And he goes to try to make it a 3-point lead and break a tie. And he missed it. And Louisville gets it. Derwin Webb chased it down. 10:25 to go. It's a 56-56 game. Holden in the paint. Lost it. Over to the side of the basket is good. Kip Stone gets the basket. He's got seven. And Louisville edges back in front by two. 58-56. 10:11 to go. And there is a whistle and a foul. It's going to go on Kansas. And that's going to be on number 51, Eric Pauley, who came in at the timeout, his first of the game.
Well, let's see if we can see what happens inside. They call the push-off.
18 fouls now will send Louisville to the line.
You saw the push-off with the right arm by Pauley against Holden.
And Holden has hit 9 out of 10 from the line. Louisville 58, Kansas 56. 10 minutes, 11 seconds to go. Holden now 9 out of 11.
Now, see, that's just like a turnover. It's a bonus. You miss it, and Kansas gets the ball.
Jamison misfired, and Derwin Webb there for the rebound. Louisville up by two. Holden double team. Stone hits another one. He's got a hot hand tonight.
And that's a three.
61 to 56. Second three-pointer of the night. Everett Sullivan and Stone have collected the threes. Rex Walters cut off. 61-56. Stone's three-pointer gives Louisville a five-point cushion. Pauly, he goes up and gets the own rebound by Ostertag. Back to Rex Walters. And Kansas couldn't get that one to fall. LeGree with a good pass to Stone and a big move by Stone.
What a difference, David. When you push it up the floor like that, Louisville's done a terrific job all night of not waiting, not hesitating, getting it up the floor in a hurry.
63-56, Louisville by 7. Ostertag, he got it. Well, Ostertag, he's got an advantage because Holden has the three fouls and doesn't want to get the fourth one.
You know, I'd like to have seen this game a couple of years ago. What a matchup between Ostertag and Felton Spencer, huh?
Louisville has a seven-point lead. Now it's at 5. It's 63-58. The drive by Webb and the foul is going to go on Pauly, and that'll be 2 on number 51, the junior, Eric Pauly, out of Buena Park, California.
And that's the 19th foul on Kansas. That means from this point on, Louisville will get 2 free throw opportunities with plenty of time, 8:38. You hate to say it, it all comes down to free throw shooting.
Roy Williams just made a massive substitution as Ostertag came out. He's resting Rex Walters, who's a really impressive guard. He's got Adonis Jordan, Richie in there, Ben Davis. This is Derwin Webb. And he'll get the next one. 64-58. Louisville's biggest lead tonight was 9. Kansas has been up by 5. And all in the second half, all of Kansas leads. Big free throws by Derwin Webb. He's got 7. Louisville leads by 7. 8.5 minutes to go in this one. Woodbury, number 20, is in the game in the backcourt. Along with Adonis Jordan against Miner. Boy, blew right by Miner. The quickness of Adonis Jordan. At 5'11", tremendous quickness and a burst of speed. Derwin Webb was open, did not want that shot. Drives all the way down, dishes it off to Miner, who scores. And Louisville's up 67-60.
But who made it happen? Webb, because he penetrated. He took it to the basket, didn't wait.
7:40 to go in this game. Woodbury to Richie, and they work it around. Shot clock has got a lot of time, 30 seconds to go now. Game clock's at 7.5 minutes. Three-pointer. Adonis Jordan, a 56% three-point shooter.
And he wanted it, David. He didn't hesitate at all. He drilled it.
And that 56%, he hit 17 out of 30 coming into the game tonight.
You know, Kansas as a team, though, is only 4 of 14. That's well below their team average. Louisville, 3 out of 5.
Here's Miner open. Got it. Greg Miner, 6 points this half, 8 in the game for Miner. And Louisville now back by 6. Every time Kansas makes a run, Louisville has been able to withstand it and add to the lead.
What was our first thing we mentioned on the Bud game plan? Confidence. And Louisville's had it from the get-go tonight.
Kip Stone tries to shut off Adonis Jordan, who threw up an air ball. A foul, and a reaction underneath will tell you it's going to go on Greg Miner, and that'll be 3 on Miner.
Got out of position. Penetration and the rebound.
That's 4 on Miner. They officially have 4 on Miner now. 4 on Morton, 3 on Holden, and Troy Smith. Miner with 6 points this second half after scoring 2 in the first half. Irwin Webb goes to the bench. Jermaine Wingfield is back in, who picked up 4 points in the first half. Adonis Jordan, a 77% free throw shooter. As he Richard Scott back, 6'7 sophomore from Little Rock. So Miner is out with four personal fouls. Jordan, two out of two. It's a four-point Louisville lead. 6:39 to go from Allen Fieldhouse. We'll be back.
Defense has really been pretty good both ways. It's been that kind of game.
Kansas has been forcing a tremendous number of turnovers in its last three games. And Louisville has not fallen victim to that. The Cardinals with a four-point lead and the basketball. Kip Stone, double-teamed, will come back as the Cardinals work for the shot. Now Holden is going to have to do something, and he gets it out there to Troy Smith, who's back. And the Cardinals show the patience as the shot clock is inside 15. Jermaine Wingfield, nice pass. Smith put it up, no good, but the rebound. Wingfield, no good. It rolled off.
Too good shot.
Tough break for Wingfield. Jameson. Jayhawks work their offense. Shot is, or clock is inside 5 or 6 minutes. They got a foul on Louisville on Wingfield. That's going to be the first on Tremaine Wingfield.
But now both teams will shoot two free throws from here on out, David. And free throw shooting, we've already seen it cost Louisville a couple of games. It's helped Kansas most of the season. Comes down to that. Denny Crum. Be interesting to see. He's walking. He's standing right in front of Dwayne Morton right now, trying to make the decision when he's going to bring Dwayne back in, who's played so well offensively but has four fouls.
Lonzo Jameson, he's hit 78% on the season from the line. He's got 9 points in the second half, 11 in the game, and now 12. The Jayhawks are hitting 63% as a team, free throw shooting almost the same as Louisville. Average Sullivan is going to be double-teamed, but gets rid of it in time. Now Average Sullivan's trapped. But they work it out.
Another trap.
Kansas defense starting to disrupt the Louisville offense. They go back now. They want to get the ball inside.
Yeah, you got to keep it out of the corners. That's where the trap is. Holding.
Almost lost it. Now Sullivan shot up. It doesn't fall, and the foul is on Kansas. And I believe that's on Walters.
Now you see Everett Sullivan dribble it down to the baseline here. Fall away. A little contact on the arm by Walters. He was complaining as soon as he heard the whistle, which most likely means he's guilty.
That's three on Rex Walters. Now Everett Sullivan, who has hit 3 for 4 tonight. 10 points in the game. As you said, Don, these are all big free throws.
So many games are decided at the charity stripe, and it's all concentration and confidence.
71-67, 5 minutes, 4 seconds to go.
Kansas seems a little bit disoriented.
Woodbury. Steve Woodbury, 6 points from off the bench. A sophomore hits a big one, 71-69.
He did. And Stone tried to pick up the charge. Now the crowd will become a huge factor.
Morton, Dwayne Morton, 9 points in the second half, 15 in the game, 73-69 Louisville. 4:18 left to go. Walters with a quick move to the basket. Two-point lead for the Cardinals, and it's almost thrown away by Legree. Down the lane, good pass to Morton, did not go, and the foul is on the Jayhawks. And Morton will go to the line, as it is a foul against Alonzo Jameson.
Morton with that great quickness taking it to the basket here. Legree got in trouble, but see, he can go over and pick it up. Then the penetration found the open man. Morton takes it up. They wanted a charge. Ooh, Jameson, pretty good position there, but didn't get the benefit of the call, and Morton will go to the line.
Morton with 9 points in the second half, 15 in the game.
I tell you, I think he's just going to get better every game, David, offensively.
74-71. Now Morton to try to give Louisville with 3:58 to go a 4-point lead. And he does, 75-71. Louisville back up by four. We've got 3:58 to go from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Stay with us. Holden each with three. Scott with four, and Walters and Jameson each with three for the Jayhawks. Kansas puts the ball in play. 3:57 showing. They trail Louisville by four. Walters. Jameson, the shot is blocked by Morton.
Great block.
But recovered by the Jayhawks. 3:35 to go. Rex Walters. But the whistle and the foul, they wipe it off. No basket. It's going to be on Louisville.
Holden, I believe, huh?
It's on Holden. That would be number four on Holden.
Well, down low, he got it. There you see, it all starts penetration. See, that's what Walters, even though he almost lost it there, you see the contact.
Scott just missed.
He's a horrendous free throw shooter. We talked about that earlier.
38% on the year.
Matter of fact, his free throw shooting, because he gets a lot of efforts, David, really brings that overall team percentage down for Kansas.
They put the ball back up and in.
Well, they got
Jameson.
They ended 75, up with two out of it, didn't they?
75-73. 3:20 to go. Pip Stone cannot get it to go. Holden with a rebound, and he's fouled. Holden is fouled, and he has been the top free throw shooter for Louisville tonight. That foul goes against number 20, Woodbury.
Well, you saw the penetration by Kip Stone. Tremendous offensive rebound. Roy Williams and some of the fans that are right behind us, you can probably hear through our mic, thought it was an over-the-back. But I thought that was just good hustle by Holden to get that offensive rebound and the stick-back opportunity.
Holden is at the line. He hit 9 out of 11 there tonight. At this end of the court, they don't have quite the distraction that they do at the foul line on the other end in the student section.
This is when they're really critical.
He got it. Louisville by three. 76-73. 3 minutes and 11 seconds to go. Boy, what a game. Fourth-ranked and undefeated Kansas trying to come back on Louisville. The Cardinals have led almost entirely this game, except early in the second half when the Jayhawks got up by seven. Louisville came back and tied this at 56, and then they have gone on to take leads of their own twice by seven, 67-60, and now they cling to a 3-point lead on the Jayhawks. Clock is down to 2:46 to go. This is a three.
Got to get out there on
the Rex Walters. Walters has just tied the game at 76. 2.5 minutes to go. Morton comes right back and gets his fifth field goal of the second half. 78-76 Louisville. 2 minutes and 17 seconds to go. Walters has it taken away.
Now, patience.
Tried to get it through Holden's legs, but Cornelius was there to make the stop. The clock's at 2 minutes. And LaGree fired one off of Morton out of bounds. Denny Crum wanted them to settle down.
No need to hurry there at all. They had 30-something seconds on the shot clock, and Denny now shouting out to Keith, hey, keep your composure. You got to hang on to it. And couldn't take advantage of running that one down, so the Jayhawks get it back.
They get it back with 2 minutes and 1 second showing on the clock. And Louisville is leading by two at 78-76. The officials are over at the official scoring table conferring.
I have no idea what this discussion's about.
Well, Roy Williams is out speaking to the officials now. Let's check our AmeriCorps long-distance scoreboard. Kentucky, a 21-point victory over Florida. Virginia Tech in the Metro beats VCU by a point. Indiana by 16 over Wisconsin in the Big Ten. UNC Charlotte beat South Florida in a key Metro matchup today. Second half, Iowa leads Purdue. And that's our AmeriCorps long-distance scoreboard. Louisville by two. Inside 2 minutes. Jordan, who's that dangerous three-point shooter. They're trying to get him free. They got Morton guarding him, or Minor, rather, guarding Adonis Jordan. Walters. Follow. Tip, tip. Back to Louisville. The Cardinals with the ball and a two-point lead, and now they slow it down. 1:26 to go. Here's Morton. Puts it up. It's no good, and he's fouled. So Dwayne Morton will get the pressure free throws. And that foul is on Eric Pauley, his third.
This is what we were talking about, David. Somebody that wants the ball, takes the ball. And who wants it tonight? Dwayne Morton. He doesn't get it down here, but he does go to the line. You could see the confusion in the VCU game. Nobody really wanted to have the ball and take control late in that game. Somebody's got to do it, even if they don't have success. And Morton's been the man tonight.
Morton with 18 points. Missed it. Well, he's got 19 points officially. Dwayne Morton has 19, and this free throw could give him 20 and give the Cardinals a three-point lead. He got it. Louisville by three, 79-76. 1:18 to go. Kansas with two good three-point shooters on the floor. Rex Walters makes a drive inside, and it's knocked away. Good defense by the Cardinals, because
yeah.
Walters has got a tremendous move to the basket.
He does. Now, Roy Williams with 28 seconds on the shot clock, 1:02 on the game clock. He wants to talk about it.
1:02 left. A lot to cheer about for themselves.
They do indeed. Fourth time in 8 years, national championship. Congratulations to James Speed. His first title, the other three, of course, Cheryl Travis was the coach. And matter of fact, Kansas finished fifth in that competition. So they did a routine together here in this game at halftime.
Let's reset it for you. 1 minute, 2 seconds to go. Kansas with the ball, trailing Louisville, 79-76. Adonis Jordan and Rex Walters, both good three-point shooters. LaGree, nobody can get it. LaGree has it. Throws it away to Ostertag. Jordan, 4-3. Missed it. Big rebound by LaGree, who is fouled, and the clock stops with 36 seconds to go. Hang on. To your seat.
February 13th, 1990, the last time Kansas lost at home, and that's been some time ago. Last time they lost to a non-conference foe, it was Duke in the 83-84 season.
They free throws tonight. Louisville has been hitting them, and so has Kansas. 4-point lead. Big free throws by Legree. 80 to 76, Louisville.
Now Louisville will, without a doubt, watch Kansas shoot the three, but doesn't want to foul here.
He missed it, and Sullivan is there to grab the rebound, and Adonis Jordan fouled him. And that'll send Everick Sullivan to the line. He's hit three out of four this second half from the line.
You know, in this building, you want to add another one to that, David? They're 35-1 in this building the last 3 years. Well, who do you foul here? Those are the shooting percentages. None of them very good.
Sullivan's shot is up and no good. Everett gets one more. Louisville leads by four with 34 seconds to go. He got that one. And so now it is 81-76 with 33 seconds to go. Kansas, 28 seconds. Here's the shot for three by Adonis Jordan. Rebound, fight for it. Whistles. They're going to call it a jump ball possession arrow, Louisville.
Kenny Crum thought, hey, that's got to be a foul. But as you pointed out, David, the arrow points toward the Cardinals. But now they're going to have to get it in bounds, but they're going to talk about it first.
20 seconds to go. Louisville 81 and Kansas 76. And we're going to stay here with it as the teams go to their respective benches. It has been 24 straight victories here that everybody thought they should have won. They only scored 57 points. Tonight they have 81 points and have held Kansas so far to 76. The Jayhawks have been averaging 91.6.
Louisville has to get it inbounds here.
McGree was open. They didn't see him, and they get it to Holden. 17 seconds, and they immediately foul Miner.
Now, tell me that's not an intentional foul. See, that was the point I was trying to make earlier. There's no doubt. Everybody in the place knows that Kansas is going to foul. Now, that to me was more of an intentional foul than earlier in the game when they called it on board. It's something that has too much judgment in it that I think shouldn't be in the game.
That's it for Alonzo Jamison. That is his fifth foul. And so he's out. Miner is a 74% free throw shooter, but he hasn't made one yet tonight. He's had a couple of tries. Jamison goes out. He scored 12 points in the second half, 14 in the game. Ben Davis, the freshman, comes back who started. 81-76, 16 seconds to go. This will be a major upset if the Cardinals can pull it off. And it's looking more like they will as Miner makes it a six-point game with 16 seconds left. And a seven-point game.
No fouls here.
Jordan. They cut that passing lane off, and Sullivan is grabbed by Adonis Jordan and stopped.
Now, that's not an intentional foul. Give me a break. I tell you what, they call that a hold.
Well, Dwayne Morton's already starting to celebrate. The Cardinals are all high-fiving it and looking at each other, but Denny Crum's got his mind on coaching on the bench.
Put your foot over here and kick my soapbox off, would you? I'll get off that intentional foul. We're all shaking hands over on the sideline, David. This is a big win.
Everick Sullivan, this is a tremendous victory for Louisville to knock off unbeaten Kansas on their home court.
You know, what did Coach Crum tell us, though? He said, this is going to be an up-and-down team.
You know, we talked to Roy Williams this morning, and he said all it takes to turn Louisville's season around right now is coming in here and win tonight.
Guess what?
Donis Jordan.
It's going to happen right now. Up. They took the timeout.
1.6 seconds. And the shot by Jordan makes it 85-78.
Roy says, forget it. We just wanted to stop the clock. We'll let it go. Big, big win. Big, big, big.
And Louisville has done it. They have upset the Jayhawks of Kansas at Allen Fieldhouse. A tremendous victory for Denny Crum and the Cardinals, who have turned things around after losing three out of four. This will get everybody's attention. Louisville 85 and Kansas 78. No doubt about it, the best game of the year so far by the Louisville Cardinals.
Without a question, they did the things they needed to do. Coach Crum has stuck with his team. Up and down, he said. But guess what? Dorothy could take Toto and everybody else and go home now.